Hey y'all, Soul of Destiny. Today's video is all about my winter shower routine, a few of my favorite after shower products, oral hygiene routine, and all of my tips to prevent body odor.
If you look cute while you're brushing your teeth, you ain't doing it right.
Not gonna smell like butt.
Girl, not as dried up anyway.
You need nails for that part.
I know you see that. I didn't tell you to do that.
Make my song. It ain't Christmas. Spin it like it's Christmas. Spin it like it's Christmas. I'm living like it's Christmas. It ain't
Hey y'all, it's Olive Destiny. Today's video is my shower routine, winter edition.
He loves me. What else can I say? More money in 2023. More money. I love me. Take care of me. Self-care day. I love me. Lots. It's giving it to the girls.
And I am not their YouTuber. Y'all know I give credit where credit is due. Rose Petals in the Shower credit goes to Aisha Marie. She did this in her birthday pamper routine over on her channel. And I was like, let me try that because I always just throw my flowers out once they like get kind of old.
Romantic.
So I'm going to take this shower vapor, put it on the shower floor, and it's going to release like this therapeutic aroma for like a spa-like experience while you shower. So in a previous video of Vlogmas, we went shopping together at Walmart. So I'm going to use the Dove Winter Care Body Bar. I'm going to just take this in combination with a washcloth and basically massage my body all over. And we all know Dove is love. So it's really moisturizing and it also smells really good. Don't be stingy. Make sure you're washing like everywhere. I mean everywhere. So putting on my exfoliation gloves, I am now going to take the body gel that we've also picked up from Walmart. This one is limited edition as well. It smells really good.
Ooh,
it smells really good. It smells like nutmeg and sweet cream. I did notice that it will temporarily stain whatever you're choosing to wash with, but as you're washing, the stain goes away. So that wasn't really a big deal to me. So exfoliation gloves come in handy for removing dead skin, which then in turn makes the skin even more soft. I personally like to use my exfoliation gloves 2 to 3 times a week. For my vaginal area, I'll be taking the Honey Pot Sensitive Foaming Wash. External use only, wash my vaginal area with this. Of course, use whatever you would like. I like to use feminine hygiene products specifically formulated to match the vaginal areas pH. Y'all so nosy watching me shower. And I washed like my vaginal area for 1 minute, following up with the Zero Taboos foaming wash under the armpits to remove any body odor in that area. So I picked up some replacement cartridges for my razor. This is the Gillette Venus one. It's for pubic hair and skin, and it does have like an irritation defense bar. So I'm just gonna pop my old one off and replace that. I was gonna take my shaving gel, but when my hands are like slippery in the shower, I cannot get anything to come out. Comment down below if you can relate. So I just grabbed the Dove Winter Care. This is the body wash version of the same bar soap that I just used, and I'm just gonna shave with that basically. So I start from the bottom and I work my way up to the top. Since the Dove is super moisturized, it left my legs feeling like, ooh, silky smooth. This video is not necessarily like product specific, but it is kind of like steps specific. So you want to use a body wash. You want to use a feminine wash. You want to make sure that you're washing your legs. You want to make sure you're scrubbing your feet. It's fine if y'all like, oh, we're not getting pedicures in the winter, but don't be like walking around with them looking crusty, ashy, dry. Your feet keep you grounded. You need to take care of them year round. So for the feet, I have this Petty Scrub Foot Buffer. It lasts for up to 10 washes. It has soap on it, right? So you can kind of like massage your feet with this. The scrub like sponge portion of it helps to further soften and cleanse your feet. After that, while the product is still on my skin, I like to take this pumice stone, buff away at the dead skin. This is great for in between pedicures. If you do your own pedicures at home, this is just like your weekly shower maintenance. I do this at least 2 to 3 times a week. If any guys have stumbled across this video for whatever reason, be sure to sign up for my OnlyFans. What you thought I wasn't gonna promo myself? Link is in the description box.
You want special till I make you so. You better act like you know.
But let's talk about the fact that I just attempted to position my camera up here on the counter. The microphone fell inside of the candle that I lit at the beginning. I'm waiting on it to dry so I can peel the wax off of it. And this is my new mic. I hope y'all can hear me because I didn't double check. But that shower was so fun. When we kind of do our little DIY rose bouquets together, I've seen in the comments where a lot of y'all say that you all like flowers as well. So when they are almost done for, because I couldn't bring myself to do it with my brand new roses. But when they're almost done, girl, you gotta try it. You gotta try it at least once. It was fun. As long as you have something that kind of, if you have the type of drain that'll catch things, do it. If not, I didn't tell you to do that. Let me finish my skincare routine. And be SPF. I'm gonna breeze through the skincare really fast since it's not really different just because it's winter time, and I'll show y'all the portion that is different. I was unbagging, you know how you like get a lot of samples. I was unbagging a lot of different samples that I had just from different purchases I've been making. So this is the Beauty Bio Bright Eyes. It's for depuffing and brightening eye gels with restorative colloidal silver.
So I'm gonna take these and I'm going to put these under my eyes for 10 minutes. You want to apply this to clean skin. Why would it fall out like that? And I'm trying to get the aesthetics. 1 second. It's ruining it, ruining it. It's stuck, okay. Now we got it. I don't want to get it too close to my eye. Smoothed it out. It feels kind of weird. But beauty is pain. It's not painful, it's just weird kind of right now. Can you hear me good? Can you hear my clock ticking in the back? 10 minutes. You need nails for that part.
So, sorry, I'm gonna go back and forth between. I'm trying to give you ASMR, I'm trying to give you whisper, I'm trying to give you aesthetics, I'm trying to give you all of destiny, I'm trying to give you ratchet destiny, I'm trying to give you everything at once. Oral hygiene. I'm all over the place, but I'm trying to go in a certain order. So for my oral hygiene, if y'all saw my Walmart video, where we kind of picked out some winter products together. I did get the, I should have got my vlog camera so I can do more than one shot at a time. We got to put on the socks. So I did pour it in here. The cups, you normally put your little cups right here. But I just feel like if I'm using my mouthwash 2 and 3 times a day, I'm using a lot of cups. So I just grab one of my shot glasses and I just keep that right here instead of having to get cups. So I just pump this, just a few pumps. Cheers. I used to love the Colgate Enamel Health, but I think they discontinued that one, or I just haven't been able to find it that much. So lately I've been taking the Colgate Total Whole Mouth Health, good for whitening. I like to do my mouthwash at the beginning actually to rinse everything out if you've been eating and things like that before you brush. Put it on the brush. This is the Oral-B toothbrush. It is electric one. It runs off of like an AA battery. It's like this little pen you use to pop out the brush head. So when you don't see much of the blue anymore, that's when you know to swap it out. To really up my oral hygiene, I want to invest in like a sanitizer, because I feel like when we just rinse our toothbrushes off, you may still leave germs on the toothbrush itself. Yeah, I've been browsing Amazon for like sanitizers, and I think that'd be like a good Christmas gift, like a stocking stuffer, if you wouldn't be giving it to people who would take it the wrong way, like people that's into oral hygiene and just like hygiene at all. And you want to make sure you get in like everywhere, bottom, top, pause. When you get the outside, you want to get over in the inside as well, like this side and then that side. 2 minutes. If you look cute while you're brushing your teeth, you ain't doing it right. After the 2 minutes of brushing my teeth, I like to take my tongue gel. This is the tongue gel. It includes natural ingredients and zinc to help cure bad breath. And then this is what you call a tongue brush. The reason that I like to use an actual tongue brush along with my toothbrush, if you all can see the size of the bristles, is different. I was reading online and basically the size of this one being like shorter bristles like this is more effective than using your toothbrush to clean your tongue basically. I used to have that other kind, like the metal kind that you just kind of scrape it down with. But then I saw this and I was like, oh. Following the directions, basically, I'm going to extend the tongue and gently brush for about 10 seconds. Most bacteria are located toward the rear of the tongue. Brush your tongue when you brush your teeth. After that, I just make sure that I clean it out very well. Okay, so that's our 10 minutes for these. Play, and I'm going to put these on. I have no idea where these are from. No idea. Like, they don't say anything. It just expires a day before my birthday next year. And I use lip scrubs and things like that, but I never did a lip mask. Like, an actual... I broke it. Trying to slide it out. Girl, not as dried up anyway. You a lie. I thought you said you expire next year. Put that in the trash. Let me know what lip mask y'all use. I like to take it a step further. Use my Bath & Body Works lip gloss. This one is minty. Naturally Sunny, I feel like, put everybody onto these. Yeah. And since it has like a mint to it, it's even more freshness. I keep the icebreaker mints in my nightstand. Since it's holiday time, you can usually find these as well. Pop one in for extra fresh breath.
Can you see a difference? I need to make sure you...
Do you rinse after?
It doesn't say.
Oh God.
It just says that it can also be used on the nose and mouth.
I have no idea.
In addition to whatever your skincare consists of in the winter, I like to at least take an oil to kind of go on top to lock in the moisture further. I'm going to put a picture right here of the L'Oreal moisturizer that I've been loving since it's upstairs. I just like to put a oil on top in the winter time. The skincare routine is just going to be given. That's like my tip for winter, locking in the moisture. Let's cover deodorant and everything. I don't know why I'm going out of order. So you can use whichever deodorant you want. If y'all want me to do a video literally going through the bottom of my cabinet showing y'all all of my products, let me know. I have like 5 or 6 different deodorants, but I'm going to use the Dove Even Tone one today. I've been attempting to wax my underarms instead of like shaving them. They're not like all the way light yet, but to see that this says Even Tone, I'd be like, okay, period. So this is the Even Tone Calming Breeze deodorant. I like to use the Lomi deodorant. If y'all have seen any of the YouTube ads, that's how I got sucked into buying this, because I saw too many of them. I was like, I want that. It's for the underarms and your private parts. But in the summertime, if you're that kind of person that sweats underneath your breasts, you can kind of like rub a dab or two. A pea-sized amount is what they say on the commercial. But for older, in the winter, summer, whenever, I take this much of it and you literally put it right at the top part of the butt. The part that looks just like this where the line is. And I just put it there like that. Not inside. You're not inserting this like in the butt. But I kind of just rub that top part where that little crease is. This is natural. It's aluminum free, baking soda free, and fragrance free. We're so used to all of our products smelling really good that this may not be for everybody. But once it dries down, I more so care about the benefits of it. It's your own body, so I'm gonna just say it. If you were to check the next morning, if I go upstairs and I sit down and edit for 3 hours and you like double check or something like that, it's not gonna smell like natural ingredients, but it's also not gonna smell like butt. And I love that. If you wanna target all of the areas where odor come from, that's why I like to take this. If you kinda sweat in the front area, maybe the inner thighs or something for my thicker girls, you know? Yeah, check this out. You don't have to get unscented. I just like to give my body a break sometimes from using all scented products. So that's how I ended up getting the unscented one. I have the regular deodorant, the roll-on stick. And then this is the tube kind. The Witch Hazel. McKenna Walker is the reason that I started doing this. This is not the exact one she uses when I did that little Dollar Tree video. That's how I had grabbed this. I'm going to get like the Thayer's, the one that she has. Once this one runs out. So you basically can take some of this, put it on a cotton pad. Actually, I always go out of order when I film. But you would take this and you wipe with it as if it's like a tissue. I don't do all the way front to back. I just do back. And I just kind of wipe with that. And it just kind of removes any extra odor. And then that's when I would put on this deodorant. So that's the order for that. For the vaginal area, I do have a lot of the Honey Pie wipes. So you can use that as well. I actually always keep one of those in my purse. Just for like a touch up on the go. I did get my wax yesterday, so I would apply the daily soothing serum. You know, you can't apply anything like immediately after, but since this is like next day, y'all will see that video separately. I'm posting out of order. 2 pumps of the Venus Gillette Venus daily soothing serum. A little goes a long way, And after doing the witch hazel, I would just massage this into the area. Yeah, just for like soothing. Then, what else? We need to moisturize the body. I got so many options. Oh my God, I don't know which one to show y'all. Do this. I have been in the habit of, because I cleaned out underneath my cabinets, so I've been in the habit of reaching for the things that I haven't been reaching for, trying to rotate a little bit more. So today I'm going to take the Watch Me Whip Hard Working Whipped Body Cream. It's like a vanilla scented one. It smells really good. And I figured I would use vanilla since this product, y'all know I love this oil. It's by one of my subscribers, Sassy Beauty, No Skin Left Behind Mahogany Vanilla Body Oil. Whichever lotion you want to apply, apply that first. Obviously this is YouTube, but honestly I apply my lotion and my oil immediately after getting out of the shower before I put the robe on. That way, especially during the winter, you're not like having back breakouts because of your back being dry and then the friction from your clothes is like breaking you out. So that's what I recommend, doing it before you even get dressed. But obviously keep in mind what you're going to wear for the day, because sometimes putting too much oil on your skin can mess up your clothes if it's like a silky robe or like a silky outfit or something. This one smells so good. Oh my God. So for the winter care, that's what the girls asked me for, because I like a glow year round. But in the winter, oil serves the purpose of locking the moisture in. I'm not mostly water-based, but when you think of a moisturizer, that's what makes it moisturizing. It's because of more liquid water type of ingredients. Oil and water don't mix. So putting oil on top of anything, the same way we put the oil on top of our face, it's a barrier that you're building to not like dry out when you go outside. So I take about 3 pumps. Do you see the glow? I know you see that. Yeah, that's what we want. Okay, so what's the lighting looking like? What is it looking like? What is it doing? So that is pretty much it for my winter shower routine and then my post body care with a little bit of the oral hygiene and just a few winter tips. I hope you all enjoyed this video. Most important, people don't like to hear this tip, but you do want to make sure that you're drinking your water when it comes to the hygiene portion of things, because you are what you eat and you are what you put into your body. And not only that, but water does help to kind of flush things out. I'm about to throw on my waist trainer, which has nothing to do with the winter body care. but I'm about to throw on my waist trainer and head upstairs so that I can go ahead and get this edited for you all. Since I'm posting out of order, I wanted to post this before I did another vlog style video. So I hope y'all enjoyed it. I will link as many products as I can down below. I'm about to keep my cute little, can y'all see them? My cute little socks on. And then I'll let you all know, I guess, maybe in the next upload, if they make my feet feel like super moisturized. They got like aloe in them. If not for anything else, they're just cute. I hope y'all enjoyed this. I'll have to do more videos like this because there's so many different products. Like, you can't reach for all of them in one video. It's impossible. This is not sponsored by this. Put this down, wait. Questions or comments, be sure to leave all of that down below. And as always, I thank you all so much for watching. Bye.